Hello everyone, so today I would like to show you how I painted these twins guys in a dungeon, and also I would like to discuss with you a topic about how to help your art, what you can use. So enjoy the video. First, a story on how these guys came to be. So basically, this is one of the sketches that I really liked, and I always wanted to paint something that is in some sort of a hybrid or something like this. Basically, two guys connected together, like having one body. A really similar monster was and is in Dark Souls 2, I guess. Also, I think something really similar was in Dark Souls 3, like this sentinel type of a guy or something like this. In Dark Souls 2, I'm sure it was on the ship. I don't remember the location name, but pretty much this was what gave me the general idea for these guys. So this was where the idea came from. The basic brief for these guys was to create some sort of a creepy cultist, like in the masks, in the climate of Dark Souls and Bloodborne and everything, going a little bit more into the Bloodborne type of a feel. So I thought giving them some sort of a huts, giving them some sort of a tentacles and everything will be a good idea, and also presenting them in a little bit more dramatic light that later you will see how it looks will be a good idea. Also, I really wanted to experiment with the light coming from the top and being reflected from the ground to lead the silhouettes from the bottom up. So this is basically where I came with the idea for the whole setup, for the whole environment. As you can see on the painting, I was using quite a lot of different references. I basically was searching for something with a really similar vibe, with a really similar color schemes and palette and everything, just to give myself a general idea on how I should render all the forms, how it could look like. So basically this was like the long story short. In here I was heavily experimenting with different filters and everything, with some adjustments and whatnot, basically to give the whole painting this a little bit more like otherworldly character to it, like a little bit more bluish, tealish and everything, but to also include some like warmer tones like reds and everything, to match the browns of the skirts and to match the hats that, as you can see, I also removed because a friend of mine told me they look kinda cheesy and I had to agree with him. And also a like bald head kinda fits a little bit more to the way they, how they look like. So this is pretty much the story for these guys. And in here I was using quite a lot of different references because this pose was quite hard actually to paint, because it required me to like stretch the anatomy in a really weird way. Also, I had a lot of problems with fitting these guys into the canvas because I constantly felt like they are too big or they are too small, or that something is not really working well. Also in here, what was kind of a problem was to how to show clearly that they are connected together, that there are seven in the side. And I decided to play a bit more with the anatomy, so kind of to distort it a bit instead of like making it really perfect. So yeah, it was like kind of going back and forth with all the ideas on just basically how to make these guys. And in here also you can see some 3D renderings of some anatomy, and basically this is one of the things that kind of gave me the idea of talking about helping yourself with your art. Because as you can see, the anatomy in this painting is not really a spectacular type of a thing. Like, I am not really good with anatomy, but it kind of does not mean I am not able to make a painting with the anatomy that is kind of okay-ish, or like, I know how to help myself with different resources to make a better painting than I actually can. Because if I were to paint these guys without all these references that I have around me, most likely the final result will be a little bit more ugly, or I will have much harder time with actually painting these things like together. Because for me it was not a nice it was a nice painting to make, but it was not an easy painting to make, since a lot was like happening. I'm not really used to painting like more than one character on a on a canvas, and in this case this is pretty much two characters. So yeah, and the fact that I decided to not use 3D as a base was making it a little bit even harder, because I had to come up with all the perspective and everything by myself, but this was like my goal for it. But as you can see, in the end I prepared a really simple 3D mockup in 3D code, and later I rendered it in Keyshot, because I wanted to have at least a visual cue on how the shadows will behave on the body. And this is basically exactly the same thing that I did with the 3D references. Also in the top right corner, as you can see, I took a photo of myself, so you can see my swole back, and just to have like a general idea on how the muscles will more or less look, because as you can see I don't have really shredded back, but at least it gave me the idea how the scapulas will behave or how the skin will fold and whatnot. And since the back is not really that visible in this painting, I thought it was enough, and it kinda was enough, so it was working for me. And to help your paintings, basically to make everything way easier, just try to use as many references as you actually need, because it's nothing wrong with actually using different references and using different things to help you. Like, the easier you can make the work on yourself and the better result you will achieve by just making it easier, the better you end up in the end, because like you end up making a better painting, and basically you are pushing your skills way further than you would normally without all these things like happening around. So this is a really important thing to be aware of. Not necessarily you need to know how to paint everything, how to draw everything, how to deal with everything. It's okay to have some problems with painting. Like, this will happen over and over again, because pretty much every single painting is a new scenario that you need to kind of resolve, that will give you different problems, that sometimes will give you the problems that you did not even expect that will happen. And you really, like, part of becoming a really good artist, I would say, is having the ability to actually deal with these problems. So what I would say in this painting was really great for me was actually I was having a problem after a problem after a problem. Like, every single step that I did in this painting was really causing me a lot of different problems. And in here I really had to stretch like my abilities to kinda discover a way how to help myself with everything that I was doing in here. Also, the arm was a huge pain in the ass, because it was really problematic how to kinda draw it properly. As you can see, I wanted to paint it pretty much in the same way as the Madonna has in the reference, but I guess I ended up changing it a little bit more, also based on the photo that I took just by myself. And also, as you can see, I decided to go grayscale for this painting, because working in color, like from the starting color, is a really hard thing for me to do. I usually prefer to start with the values, then resolve everything in the values with all the readability and everything, with every reflected light and whatnot, because this way I don't really need to focus on how the color will behave. I can focus purely on the shapes, I can focus purely on the rendering, on the readability of everything, and later recoloring black and white painting is not that big of a deal, especially since I had some like references on the top on how I want to color it. In the end I used a little bit different color schemes and palettes and everything, but I had the general idea in my head. And this is also one of the ways that you can make a painting way easier for yourself, because if you don't really need to focus on the color, on all the textures and everything at the same time, it will be way easier for your brain to process certain informations just by having like a really simple thing to do. It's like going from A to B to C to Z to a final result. So it's nothing really that complex. Also, in here, I'm kind of glad that I tried to do it with the color, because usually like the painting went way further than I expected it to go with the colors and everything, because I was not expecting I will like go that far just by using colors basically from the start. So it was a nice experience for me. I can see that I am slowly getting better with the colors and I'm getting a little bit more confident. So yeah, and one of the problems also that you can see in here was the background, because at the beginning I wanted to make some sort of a like arena or something like this, but later I decided to make some sort of a opening like in a gate or something along these lines, because I wanted to expose the silhouettes a little bit more over the really bright background, because the vast majority of the silhouette of these two guys is way darker. So this was basically the idea for the background. Also, extremely problematic thing was a weapon, because the angle of it is really weird. It's like kind of foreshortened but not really, and it's kind of like tangent to the head but not really, and I was going like a lot of back and forth how to place it and how actually he should hold it, because as you can see on the reference that I took of myself, I'm having like the elbow bent like to the body, and in the painting he's kind of reaching a little bit more to the back, but I was kind of too lazy to get up and take another photo. So basically I had to kind of come up with all the ideas just by myself. And the whole recoloring is basically the same story. Back in the days I had no idea how to recolor the black and white paintings and whatnot, but after like following tutorial after a tutorial after a tutorial, taking some classes and everything, I pretty much developed a workflow to recolorize everything in any approach that I want. It's not necessarily a good approach, I would say, because it really varies from painting to painting, but in my case it gets the shit done and I know kinda what type of effect I can achieve with it. So if it's working for me, I will continue using it, because it is way faster for me actually to start black and white and later just do mumbo jumbo in Photoshop and to recolor everything. So in here you can see the background is kinda changing. And at this point I kind of got the idea of going a little bit more like creepy, and while painting I felt like this painting is kind of like empty, so I decided to add some like tentacles and everything just to populate the scene a little bit more and to kind of include a little bit more interesting story, because in this painting, as you can see, they kind of look like they are defending something because they are like glued together back to back, but also they have tentacles hanging from themselves. So the whole like environment also has a lot of tentacles. So it's really hard to say if they are like fighting the tentacles or if they are like one with the whole environment. So I thought it will be a little like a cool small story to include in here. And also, as you can see, I was kind of experimenting with making them a little bit more like metal. So I included a lot of like nails and everything, but I felt it looked kind of cheesy, so it was nothing really that interesting. But I really like the idea for this like forearm piece with all the spikes and whatnot. I kind of felt they kind of fit to this like heavy metal or more like a black metal type of a look, so it was definitely an interesting painting. Also, what I really like with illustrations like this, I am really pretty much designing these guys on the go. I was not really designing them before I started painting. So this is kind of like testing the design decisions in a real time. But also, as with everything, you can help yourself just by experimenting on a different files, just at some point duplicating the file into like 5 sketches and just sketching on top of them. Like everything that you can come up with that will actually help you painting, in my opinion, is a good idea. So the easier you will make it in the end for you, better for you. Like, is, I guess, that simple. So to kind of summarize what I was talking about now, what I would say, like, and what I would kind of would like you to take for granted is using references, using 3D, using your own photos, using different photos from the internet. Like basically creating your own references on, or finding your references is completely fine. And this is a thing that you should do, because there is no way you will know how everything looks. And just get inspired and just experiment with everything that you can do. At some point, after doing like 50 paintings, you will discover in which one of them a thing that was helpful for you to develop your own workflow. So I think this is a really good approach to have. And the other thing that also you should do that is kind of related to like helping yourself with the painting is to actually sometimes stop a painting and just do something else, like start another painting or something like this, because sometimes you basically will not see all the like problems that you have with the painting and you simply will not think about the solution for them. In here it kind of looks like I am painting them like from the start to the finish in like one sitting. Actually they took me like a week to do, I guess, because I was working on 5 different illustrations at the same time. So this is also a really cool tip in my opinion. If you have a lot of different like paintings that you are working on at the same time, the better it is for you, because actually if you focus on a different painting you will still be thinking a little bit more on the painting that you were doing previously. So this way maybe you will like figure out something that will look kind of cooler. So multitasking while doing illustrations in my opinion is also extremely valuable, because there is also a chance that while doing different painting, in different painting you will include something that is really cool and maybe it will like help you doing this painting, like other painting, because there is no way you will get every single idea on a one thing. Every single painting will give you different ideas that you can reapply to a different paintings. So this is pretty much the way how I was working in this one. And the tentacles and all the nails and everything and the blood on them were kinda, how to tell it, inspired by other things that I have done. And also for the whole project in here, I wanted to not use photo textures for as long as possible. But also I don't really like kicking myself with like painting all the ground and all the tiles and whatnot. So I just went to textures.com and downloaded some textures and just pretty much painted them, as you can see in here, like over painted them. And what was also kind of great, I took a lot of inspiration for the tiles and how they should be placed from a different painting that I made like back in the day. So for example, in this case, there was no need for me to like ask Konstantinos for help, because I kind of knew that he would point out like between other things the tiles being like too even. So the critique from other art, like from other artwork, was also really valuable for this one. And also asking your friends for help is a different thing that can make your art way better, because if you have like 2 or 3 friends that you believe or that you know that their critiques are valuable, then I think you should really bother them by sending everything that you do, because every input into your painting is an opinion from a different set of eyes. So most likely they will see things that not necessarily you saw, but maybe even you overlooked because you were kind of afraid or you did not wanted to admit that you want to change something. And it's a really like typical occurrence that sometimes you just by being lazy you won't change things, and it will happen. So actually giving a painting to someone else is a good idea, and also knowing where you can take your references from is also a good thing to do. So in here we have a gal from Gorgoroth, or however to pronounce it, with all this like spiky thing on his arm, and yeah, this was pretty much the reference for it. So one more time, drawing spikes from the like armband, forearm armor, however to call it, is not necessarily a hard thing, but actually seeing it in the real time gave me a little bit better understanding for it. So it was cool to use a reference. And the different thing also that is not necessarily like about this painting itself, it's more about the video, was the fact that I was trying to record this video for over 2 or 3 weeks now. I was changing the topics, I decided to like talk about this, talk about that, talk about this, and as I said in one of the previous videos, I had tons of problems, I have no idea why, with recording this video in particular, because it is kind of long and it's really hard for me as a non-native speaker to talk about any topic a little bit more in depth for that long. So I had to kind of reapply the same techniques or the same rules that I use in painting into making a videos. I was doing different videos, I started doing some live streams and everything. I practiced talking about different things in the meantime. So at some point I felt like, okay, maybe I will talk about this topic, about basically just how to make everything easier and to share my thoughts on it. So yeah, I did it, and I finally, hopefully, I believe I managed to record this video. Also in here you can see the hand reference for the painting that I took of myself, because I felt like this hand is not really a natural position for a hand for this guy. I felt like a little bit more like crooked with bending fingers and everything will feel a little bit more for this one, because it will kind of show the tension in the body itself. So yeah, this is pretty much the story for these guys. And this is, yeah, like I can only tell you, like, for example, in here I took some references with a really similar like lighting conditions, like kind of like from the top you can see it on the quads, and later it was just rendering. And one of the things that I said many times, and also that I will say over and over again, because it is extremely important, and if you are like watching my different videos you will kind of like write it down in your brain, like it will be hard-coded, that if you are doing something, always try to demand from yourself to produce the best type of a work that is possible for this current project. Not necessarily it mean it will end up being like your best painting and everything, but there is a huge chance, like if you will actually demand from yourself a better quality than usually you can deliver, most likely it will like push your skills a little bit further to the front. And yeah, this is pretty much it. So always try to be the best painter that you can while actually painting. But if you feel like kind of tired with it, also remember you can take a break or something like this, as I did many times with these guys, because when I was like collecting the videos, sometimes I was painting them for like 40 minutes, then I took a break for 3 hours, sometimes I was painting them for like 10 minutes and I felt like, okay, this is not really going well, and later I was like painting them for 3 or 4 hours straight. So yeah, this is pretty much how it goes. And also one of the things that you should really remember, always when you are watching this type of videos, usually it kind of looks like I know perfectly from the start to the finish what am I doing, that I'm kind of following like the straight line with maybe a small bumps. In the real world, to be honest, during the whole process of the painting, it was extremely scary for me to do. I was not really sure anything that I was doing, but since I already have some experience with the painting and everything, I simply had a little bit better chance of succeeding with the final result. So remember, this stuff is hard, and it's not like I made it effortlessly. It was actually challenging for me, and just by the fact that I know that it was challenging for me, I feel this painting was really a good thing to do. It taught me a lot of different things. It definitely honed my skills and showed me a little bit more like different approaches for it, for the future paintings. So if you are watching something like this, and if you will be painting even a similar type of a thingy, remember, this is not easy. It will take time, it will be hard, it will like cause a lot of different problems. Like, the best actually tip to become a good artist is to keep pushing, to don't get discouraged and everything. But this is also a thing that I have discussed many times in different videos, and that I will discuss many different times in different videos. Also in here I changed the sword from like the classical typical like straight sword into some sort of a kopesh, I guess it is written, like with this bend, because I kind of felt it fits a bit more with the overall design of the tentacles, because like the natural arc for the tentacles is like this C or S letter type of a shape. So yeah, and from the announcements, in the next week I'm starting to run a Discord server, because everything is already set. So if I do it, I will try to include the link also in the description down below. So this is the one thing. Soon I will include the full versions of these tutorials on the Gumroad. So there will be around 5 to 10 hours total for all the paintings that I have uploaded recently. The way the tutorials will look like will be most likely I will tell you what I would like you to study. So for example, there will be like pretty much a workout for you to do before starting a painting. Then you will get like a description of a painting, like a PDF or something like this, just to follow. So you will have the general idea of the topic that you want to basically create. And if you will, like for example, buy the tutorial, because I want them to be like $10 maybe each or something like this, also you will get invite, I guess it is possible to make, for like a special room in the Discord server where you can like upload your painting that you have done based on the brief. And if I will have a time, I will review it on a live stream, or I will simply review it on the Discord server. So it will be a really nice way to like interact with anyone who will kind of buy a tutorial, and also it will kind of allow me to organize everything in a little better manner. So also in there I will include some tricks that you can use in the painting and whatnot. So yeah, this is pretty much all. And in here I also decided to change the colors palette from this greenish one to a little bit more bluish reddish to make it a little bit more creepy, because I just felt it fits a little bit better, especially since every single painting that I do usually is way too dark and way too blue. So this is pretty much all. Thanks for watching. I hope like this vlog, I would say, was somewhat helpful for you, and that you learned something new and that you enjoyed the process. So if you did not, let me know in the comments. If you liked it, also let me know in the comments. If you have any questions, ask them. And thanks for watching. Subscribe, like, and have a good night or day or whatever, and see ya to the next video.